guys, it's Aoife from Words of Clover, and today I wanted to show you the books I'm planning to read for the Eurovision-a-thon, which is taking place from April 24th until May 22nd, I think. And as it kind of says on the tin, this is actually a readathon that is obviously based around the Eurovision, which is taking place at the end of May, on May 22nd. And this is a really, really fun readathon that I found out about a couple of weeks ago, and it is run by Helen over Helen's Bookhaven. I will leave her channel, the Twitter account for the readathon, down below. I've chosen 10 countries because I didn't have books for like every single country. I kind of wanted to try and stick with books I already had on my Kindle, on NetGalley, on my shelves, and that is what I'm doing. So I've only chosen 10. I've kind of going easy with myself. So yeah, I didn't want to overwhelm myself with too many books on my TBR. So I wanted to go through those 10 books with you now and the countries. So the first country I'm choosing is obviously Ireland. This is quite an easy one for me, the same with the UK. I have a lot of books set in the UK and set in Ireland on my shelves. So the book I am reading for Ireland will be Strange Flowers by Donal Ryan. Ryan is an author that I really, really enjoy. I think he just has a beautiful way of writing, and I really connect with the stories that he has told in the past that I've read. So this is kind of a short enough book. It's only about over 200 pages, and it is about a woman who in 1973, she disappears and her parents are distraught. They don't know what's happened to her, and they kind of end up having to kind of come to terms with the fact that they may never see their daughter again. And then 5 years later, she shows up again and she has someone with her, and it's to do with that kind of mystery of where she was, and then I think just the feelings of the family of what is going on and kind of having to come to terms with the fact that like they had kind of had to make their peace with the fact that she was gone and now she's come back, and I think just emotions are all over the place again. So this is one that will be very interesting in terms of how Donal Ryan writes. I think it'll be a particularly interesting story to see how he does that kind of emotions and the family and drama. I'm looking forward to reading this. The next book I have is for the UK, and I decided to pick up an ARC I received recently, and that is The Road Trip by Beth O'Leary. I've read The Flatshare by Beth O'Leary and I really, really enjoyed that. I do actually have her other, The Switch. I think I have it on NetGalley as well. But this is one, as I see, I do have it on physical copy, and I think this will just be a really fun one to read, especially as like the weather's getting a bit warmer. We might start being able to actually think about road trips soon. So the next country I've chosen is Sweden, and I'm actually going to go for Anxious People by Fredrik Backman. Fredrik Backman is an author I really, really love. I always get along with his books, and Anxious People is one I've had on my NetGalley list for a while, and I just haven't gotten around to it. As far as I know, it is about a couple, I think it might be a father and a son, who actually end up trying to rob this bank. And during this bank robbery, you kind of find out about the robbers, what's going on through their head, what's going on in their lives. I think you might also get to know like the people that are in the bank while this robbery is going on. And I think much in the way Fredrik Backman writes, he writes people and emotions, and he just has a really interesting way of bringing characters to life, and he has this really great way of just like hitting you like in the emotional feels as well with his writing. So I can't wait to read this and see if I like it as much as I've liked his other books. For Italy, I've decided to read a book on my NetGalley list that is A Trail of Pearls by D.M. George, and this is a book that is something to do with mermaids, and it has this beautiful cover with the back of a mermaid, which I'll show on screen. And as far as I know, this is about a woman who, I think she lives in Silicon Valley, and I think she's like a high flying career woman, and then I think her husband cheats on her, or something happens in her marriage where she decides like basically like feck this, I'm out, and she ends up going to the Amalfi Coast to try and pursue a career in travel writing. And when she gets to the Amalfi Coast, she meets a mermaid, and this mermaid I think does something, or like does some sort of like siren call or something to basically help this woman's romantic life, I think. But I think things start going wrong and things go a little bit dangerous and dark, and that's all I really know about this. But it kind of reminded me of that book The Pisces, which I read a while ago, and that one was really, really weird. It was to do with a woman who had like this love affair with this mermaid, and that was very strange and like kind of crude and vulgar, and it was interesting. I liked it, but I didn't love it. But this one sounds slightly similar, but probably not as weird as that one. So I'm looking forward to reading it and seeing what it's like. And yeah, I kind of want to read more books about mermaids because I really love mermaids. I really wanted to be a mermaid when I was younger. Like when I was small and I was in a swimming pool, I'd always pretend I was a mermaid. If I could be like any fantasy creature, I'd be a mermaid. So yeah, I'd love to read more books, like adult books that have something to do with mermaids. So if you have any suggestions, please leave them down below. For France, I'm going to go for The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue by V.E. Schwab. This again is one that I've had on my list for a while. It's ones I've seen people love. It's ones I've seen people hate. People who generally haven't liked Victoria Schwab's writing have actually really liked this. I feel very like mediocre about V.E. Schwab. I sometimes, like, I wouldn't be raving about her books, but I don't dislike them either. I'm just kind of getting along okay with them. So I'm eager to see if I like Addie LaRue. As far as I know, this is about a girl who ends up like selling her soul to the devil. So she doesn't have to marry someone, I think, but it ends up where she lives forever. But everyone who meets her forgets her as soon as they don't see her anymore, or as soon as they walk into an opposite room, she is forgotten. So she kind of lives her life. This very, very long life of hers is kind of almost completely invisible. And it does start off in France, so that is why I'm choosing it for France. For Russia is one I'm very excited about, and it's Tsarina by Ellen Alpston, and this is described on NetGalley, which I got it from, as Memoirs of a Geisha meets Game of Thrones, which sounds really interesting. And this is basically about the rise of Catherine I of Russia, and it's about this young servant girl called Martha who ends up meeting, I think, Peter, who is like the future Tsar of Russia, and how the two of them end up, I think, this romantic relationship, and then she eventually becomes Catherine. And yeah, I don't know anything about Catherine, but I think Russian historical fiction set in Russia is always pretty interesting, and again, it's something I would love to read more of, so I'm really excited to read this one and see if it's good. For Germany, I have another kind of post-World War II novel, and that is Miss Graham's War by Celia Rees, and this is set in 1946 in Germany, and it is about a woman who is living in Germany, and I think there's something around kind of a cookbook, and I think she's pretending that she is in Germany to kind of find out more about food or do something around like culinary arts or something to do with food and cookbooks and stuff. But what she's actually doing is she's trying to root out Nazis in hiding in Germany, writing code back to her employers about like what she's finding out, but she's hiding that code within recipes. And yeah, so that sounds very, very interesting, and I can't wait to get on with that and see again if that one's good. Now for Australia, I had two different options for Australia. Again, I don't really know why Australia is in the Eurovision. They kind of were like in a few years ago as kind of like a special thing, and then they just like never left. So yeah, we just gotta go along with it that Australia is in the Eurovision. But yes, so I have two options, and one of them is The Happiest Man in the World by Eddie Jaku. Now Eddie Jaku actually is a concentration camp survivor during World War II, but afterwards he did actually end up emigrating to Australia. He raised his family in Australia, and he now resides in Australia, so there is a connection to Australia there. I think that is what I'll probably be going for. I do have Never Night on my shelf as well, but I think this is one that kind of is calling out to me, so I think this is one that I might want to read. And for Spain, I have a book that's been on my shelves for quite a while, and that is The Queen's Vow by C.W. Gortner, and this is historical fiction, as you can see, and it's about Queen Isabella of Spain, who her husband was King Ferdinand of Spain. So this is historical fiction around Queen Isabella, and I don't really know that much around like Spanish kings and queens. Most of the historical fiction I've read around kings and queens have generally been from England. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to getting into this and seeing if it's good. And again, it's one that's been on my shelves for a really, really long time, so it'll be nice to finally read it. For Greece, I didn't have any for Greece. So that was one that I had kind of a little bit of trouble with trying to find a book that I want to read. And then I decided to just give myself, like, for some reason I was like, I really want to read a book, like kind of a summary kind of, you know, women's fiction book that's just kind of maybe nice and easy, and will just be like really nice to like fly through, especially again as the weather hopefully gets a little bit sunnier and nicer and as the end of May approaches. So I decided to just Google on Amazon to see if any kind of Kindle books came up, and one came up, which is One Summer in Santorini. And I went to Santorini actually last March, just before basically the world shut down, and myself and my boyfriend went to Santorini, and we absolutely loved it, and we would love to go back. So this is kind of a nice way of remembering our time in Santorini and thinking about what we'll do when we get back, when eventually we do get back to Santorini. But this is basically kind of what you would expect a book called One Summer in Santorini is. It's about a girl who is sick of men. She says no more boys, and she decides to go traveling. She goes to Santorini, and then she meets a boy, and I think she starts falling in love. Those are the books I'm reading. If you have any books from other countries that are that are in the Eurovision that you would also recommend, if you guys are taking part in the Eurovisionathon, I would really love to know what you guys are reading for the different countries. I think this is such a great readathon to really make you think about where you're reading from and what countries you're reading about, because really, like, predominantly, like, a lot of my books are UK and America, and like a lot of Ireland obviously as well. But it's something I want to be really conscious of, the type of books I'm reading and where I'm reading them from, because, you know, reading about the same places all the time does get a little bit boring. So it's nice to expand a little bit and travel a little bit throughout Europe and through our books at a time when we can't really travel in person. So yeah, it's a really nice thing to do, and I can't wait for the Eurovision. I'm going to really look forward to the Eurovisionathon and all these books I can't wait to read. And thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys again next time. Bye.